मॉर्निंग डियर फ्रेंड, आई प्रोफेसर हर्षा गुंडावनी फ्रॉम बीसीसीए डिपार्टमेंट एंड आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू विजुअल बेसिक डॉट नेट एंड टुडेज माय टॉपिक इज द माइक्रोसॉफ्ट डॉट नेट फ्रेमवर्क। एज यू नो माइक्रोसॉफ्ट डॉट नेट फ्रेमवर्क हैविंग सम पार्ट हाउ द माइक्रोसॉफ्ट रिलायंस ऑन विंडोज। विंडोज मीन्स ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम विंडोज। ओके, सो बेसिकली द पार्ट राइटिंग सॉफ्टवेयर फॉर विंडो। राइटिंग सॉफ्टवेयर फॉर विंडो इट इज नथिंग बट द प्रोग्राम विच इज रिटन फॉर द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम। ओके, सो एनी सॉफ्टवेयर दैट यू राइट एज टू इंटरैक्ट विद वेरियस पार्ट ऑफ ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम इन ऑर्डर टू डू इट्स जॉब। टू इट्स जॉब मीन्स वेन एवर वी रिक्वायर्ड एग्जीक्यूशन ऑफ द प्रोग्राम। सो पर्टिकुलर ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम हैविंग सेट ऑफ द प्रोग्राम टू एग्जीक्यूट इट। So you have to write that particular software which is interact with the operating system in order to do its needful job. If the software needs a block of memory to store some data in, then it interact with the memory, the management. So we have to return some program in our operating system which is requiredly execute some program which is used to memory management. If our program or our software is required to store some data into the memory, then we have the memory for storing that particular data and we have to manage that particular memory by using the memory manager. So operating system having the particular program which is used to manage the memory. So it is interact with the memory manager for the manages the memory which is required by our software or our program. Next one is to read a file from a disk. You use the disk subsystem to request the file from the network. You use the network subsystem. If our software or our program is basically based on the network based system, so operating system also required the communication between that particular network subsystem which is used for our program. So if you store the particular file on other subsystem or in network, then and your software or your program required that particular file for the execution, and so you have to read this program or your program should be read that particular file on that particular subsystem. The operating system having some set of instructions to manage that particular reading file from another subsystem, from another disk, from disk for subsystem, for network subsystem. So those are nothing but the particular software which is provided by the window for execution of our program or the software. The basic next part is the .NET framework classes. So basically why the Microsoft relies on the window? Window is nothing but the operating system. Okay, so those are the particular advantages which having some set of instructions for the calling the particular program to interact with the memory management and interact with the other subsystem or request for the request file or the network or network subsystem. So operating system having some particular set of instructions, particular program to do this job. So that's why Microsoft relies on Windows. Okay. Then the next part is the .NET framework classes. So basically Windows 32 API, that means operating system 32 API is nothing but totally object oriented. So everything is done by the object. Okay. Although this concept of the subsystem in .NET are never as directly, instead they are abstract away by the framework classes for the communication between IO files with the .NET framework classes. So basically .NET framework classes having the huge amount of classes which is interact with the or which is communicate with the IO files for the execution of our program. So this is nothing but the .NET framework is actually a set of classes called as base class also. So your application which is directly interact with the system IO file, which is interact with the PC system, that means pocket system, Linux or Windows. So basically Microsoft .NET framework is relies on the Windows because Windows having so much advantages for execution of the program. So how execute our .NET program on the framework? So basically we when we write our .NET Visual Basic .NET program, then have execution done by the classes, right? Because classes having some procedures, some functions, some required things which is required for the execution. So it is use the those already written functions, procedure or classes for the execution, like write, read, okay. So basically those part is partially done by the classes library, but afterwards it having or those particular code have to be converted into Microsoft 86 instructions, that is also known as assembly language or alternatively called as machine code. This basically high level language, then middle level language, then low level language. So our program should convert it into middle level language, that is nothing but the machine code or assembly language. So if you once you have written your code that interact with the classes, you still need to run it. So this pose a strictly problem to remove the reliance on the platform, to the remove the reliance on the processor, because we directly not rely on the processor for the execution or not rely on the Windows, okay, for the execution. So if you wrote your application Visual Basic 6, this is the example actually. If you wrote your application, that means your software or your program, right, wrote in Visual Basic 6, so it is directly converted into 86 instructions, which is also called as machine code or assembly. Okay, before you could deploy it, the machine code would then be installed and execution on the machine that part support 86 instructions. Okay, in Visual Basic 6, but VB.NET having some extra part. What is it? The language that computer use in machine code, sometimes called as machine instructions, when you are using the PC with an Intel or compatible processor, this language is more specifically known as 86 machine instructions. But when we use this code, so basically this program is compatibly converted or compiled with the something Microsoft Intermediate Language. So it is also called as MISL. The program would only run on Intel chip and their compatible competitors. Instead compilation creates sometimes called as Microsoft Intermediate Language or MISL. This language is not dependent on the any processor. That means when we required some execution, so we need the processor for the processes. So basically some processor is dependent for the particular languages. So here .NET framework having the part that is called as Microsoft Intermediate Language. So our program code is converted into MSIL, which is not dependent on the processor. That's why it is called as platform independent language, because it is not dependent on the processor. And as you know, Microsoft .NET framework having the large amount of collection of the programming code or collection on the means, that means we create many languages program on one platform. That is nothing but the we can create the C# program, we can create the VB.NET program, we can create the ASP.NET program. So .NET framework provide us the platform to create multi language program on one platform. So that's why it is platform independent. That particular thing is done by the MSIL. So this language is not dependent on any processor. It is a layer above traditional machine code. So basically, when we wrote our program in Visual Basic .NET, it is converted into MSIL, which is nothing but the alternative machine code, which is layered on the traditional machine code language. So MSIL code will not just run on any processor, as processor do not understand this. Okay, so we need to convert this MSIL native code into the processor code, that is nothing but the 86 machine instruction. So this is nothing but the figure which is the example of execution code, which is simply when we write the Visual Basic source code, it is simply compiled by the compiler, and compilation can convert this into 86 instructions. Okay, but in Visual Basic .NET, when we use when we wrote our code on Visual Basic .NET, then those Visual Basic .NET compiler having the MSIL, that is nothing but the Microsoft Intermediate Language, which is does not understand by the processor. Okay, so after that, this MSIL is converted into 86 native compiler code, which is understandable by any processor. So it will convert our code into instruction set of processor. So that's why our program is platform independent, and that's why Microsoft relies on the Windows. Okay guys, this is all about the execution. We further continue with the common language runtime. Okay, and the features of common language runtime, which is provided on the VB.NET for the execution. So keep watching our next video and keep happy learning. Thank you.